दुले दुले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाए, दुले दुले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाए। आसिया वृंदावने नाचे गौर राय, आसिया वृंदावने नाचे गौर राय, दुले दुले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाए, डोले डोले गौरा चांद। वृंदावने तरुलता प्रेम कोय हरि कथा, प्रेम कोय हरि कथा, निकुंज रपके गोली हरि नाम सुनाए, निकुंज रपके गोली हरि नाम सुनाए, धुले धुले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाए, डोले डोले गौरा चांद। गौरा बोले हरे हरे, सारे बोले हरे हरे, गौरा बोले हरे वाले हरे हरे, मुखे मुखे सुख सारे हरि नाम गाए, मुखे मुखे सुख सारे हरि नाम, दुले दुले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाए, दुले दुले गौरा चांद। हरि नामे मत्त होए, हरिणा असिचे दे, हरिणा मयूर मयूरे प्रेमे नाचिया खेलाय, मयूर मयूर प्रेम नाचिया खेला, डोले डोले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाए, डोले डोले गौरा चांद। प्राणे हरि ध्याने हरि, हरि बोलो मदन भरि, हरि नाम गे रस गले जाए, हरि नाम गे दुले दुले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गा, আসিয়া যমুনার কুলে নাচে হরি হরি বলে যমুনা উথলে সে চরণ ধোয়া যমুনা উথলে সে দুলে দুলে গৌরাচার হরি গুণ গায়ে ধুলে ধুলে গৌরাচা আসিয়া বৃন্দাবনে নাচে গৌররায় আসিয়া বৃন্দাবনে নাচে গৌররায় হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে 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 রাম 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 হরে হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে 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 রাম 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 হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে 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 রাম 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 হরে 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 রাম হরে রাম 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 হরে হরে দুলে দুলে গৌরাচার হরি গুণ গায়ে জয় জয় শ্রী চৈতন্য জয় নিত্যানন্দ জয় দ্বৈত চন্দ্র জয় গৌর ভক্ত বৃন্দ জয় জয় শ্রী চৈতন্য জয় নিত্যানন্দ জয় দ্বৈত চন্দ্র জয় গৌর ভক্ত বৃন্দ জয় জয় শ্রী চৈতন্য জয় নিত্যানন্দ জয় দ্বৈত চন্দ্র জয় গৌর ভক্ত বৃন্দ জয় দ্বৈত চন্দ্র জয় গৌর ভক্ত শ্রী শ্রী গৌর নিতাই কি কলিযুগ পাবন হরিনাম সংকীর্তন কি শ্রী বৃন্দাবন ধাম কি শ্রীল প্রভুপাদ কি সমাবেত ভক্ত বৃন্দ কি নিতাই গৌর প্রেমানন্দে ওম অজ্ঞান তিমিরন্তস্য জ্ঞানাঞ্জন শলাকয়া চক্ষুঃ উন্মীলিতম যেন তস্মৈ শ্রী গুরবে নমঃ শ্রী চৈতন্য মনোভীষ্টম স্থাপিতম যেন ভূতলে স্বয়ং রূপ কদা মহ্যম দদাতি স্বপদান্তিকম বন্দেহম শ্রী গুরোঃ শ্রীযুত পদ কমলম শ্রী গুরুন বৈষ্ণবাংশ্চ শ্রীরূপম সাগ্রজাতম সহ গণ রঘুনাথান্বিতম তম সজীবম সাদ্বৈতম সাবধূতম পরিজনাসহিতম কৃষ্ণ চৈতন্যদেবম श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सह गण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादि पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू, वी आर प्रोसीडिंग विद द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर टुडे, 17th चैप्टर ऑफ द मध्यलीला चैतन्य चरितामृत। लॉर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु ट्रैवल्स टू वृंदावन, देयरफॉर वी सैंग द सॉन्ग दुले दुले गौरचान। सो प्लीज रीड द समरी ऑफ द चैप्टर मध्यलीला 17th चैप्टर, लॉर्ड ट्रैवल्स टू वृंदावन।
The following summary of 17th chapter is given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur in his Amrita Pravaha Bhashya. After attending the Rath Yatra ceremony of Sri Jagannath, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu decided to start for Vrindavan. Sri Ramananda Rai and Swarup Damodar Goswami selected a Brahmana named Balabhadra Bhattacharya to personally assist Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Early in the morning before,
so this is sunrise. the first 20 verses are on this theme which he read just now. That means Lord Chaitanya gets permission from the devotees to go to Vrindavan, and he agrees to take with him a servant known as Balabhadra Bhattacharya.
Early in the morning before sunrise, the Lord started for the town of Kataka. North of the Kataka, he penetrated a dense forest and came upon many tigers and elephants, whom he engaged in chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Whenever the Lord had a chance to visit a village, Balabhadra Bhattacharya would beg alms and acquire some rice and vegetables. If there were no village, Balabhadra would cook whatever rice remained and collect some spinach from the forest for the Lord to eat. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very pleased with the behavior of Balabhadra Bhattacharya. In this way, the Lord passed through the jungle of Jharkhand and finally reached Varanasi. After taking his bath at the Manikarnika Ghat at Varanasi, he met Tapan Mishra, who took the Lord to his place, respectfully gave him a comfortable residence at Varanasi. Vaidya Chandrasekhar, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's old friend, also rendered service unto him. Seeing the behavior of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, a Maharashtrian Brahmana informed Prakashananda Saraswati, the leader of Mayavadi Sannyasis. Prakashananda made various accusations against the Lord. The Maharashtrian Brahman was very sorry about this, and he brought the news to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, inquiring from him why the Mayavadi Sannyasi did not utter the holy name of Krishna. In reply, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that they were offenders and that one should not associate with them. In this way, the Lord bestowed his blessings upon the Brahmana. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu next passed through Prayag and Mathura and then took his lunch at the home of a Sanodiya Brahmana, a disciple of Madhavendra Puri. He bestowed his blessings upon the Brahmana by accepting lunch at his place. Thereafter, the Lord visited the 12 forests of Vrindavan and was filled with great ecstatic love. As he toured the Vrindavan forest, he heard a chirping of parrots and other birds.
Yeah. So this is a summary. So as you heard now, The first section, 20 verses, are talking about Mahaprabhu taking permission from the devotees and accepting Pallavadri Bhattacharya and traveling with him, which we will discuss today. And then another 21 to 56 verses is Lord Chaitanya passing through the Jharikhanda forest. And the animals and birds chanting and dancing by seeing Lord Chaitanya. And then there is a section about Mahaprabhu thanking Balabhadra Bhattacharya for his service. And Balabhadra Bhattacharya pleasing Lord Chaitanya. Then after that, visiting different places like Varanasi, delivering Prakashanand Saraswati. Then Mahaprabhu arriving at Mathura. And also Mahaprabhu meeting Sanadiya Brahman. These are important incidents. And then finally Mahaprabhu traveling to Vrindavan. So let's proceed with the first section now. Gacchan Vrindavanam Gauro. Repeat.
Vanam Gauro.
Vyagre Bhaina Kagan Vane.
Vyagre Bhaina Kagan Vane.
Premon Matan Sahon Rityan.
Premon Matan Sahon Rityan.
Vidade Krishna Jalpinaha.
Vidade Krishna Jalpinaha. On his way to Vrindavan, Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu passed through the forest of Jharikhanda and made all the tigers, elephants, deer, and birds chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and dance. Thus, all these animals were overwhelmed by ecstatic love.
Jaya Jaya Gaura Chandra Jaya Nityananda.
Jaya Jaya Gaura Chandra Jaya Nityananda.
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda.
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. All glories to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. All glories to Lord Nityananda. All glories to Advaita Acharya, and all glories to all the devotees of the Lord.
Sharat Kala Haila Prabhura Chalite Haila Mati.
Sharat Kala Haila Prabhura Chalite Haila Mati.
Ramananda Swarupa Sange Nibrite Yukati.
Ramananda Swarupa Sange Nibrite Yukati. When autumn arrived, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu decided to go to Vrindavan. In a solitary place, he consulted with Ramananda Rai and Swarup Damodar Goswami.
Yeah. Earlier devotees said, "Oh Lord, it's very cold time of the year. You know, December, January, February. You can't go." And later on devotees say, "Oh Lord, this is a very hot season of the year. You can't go. It may not be good to travel." Then they would say, "Oh Lord, now it's a rainy season, Chaturmas, let it get over." But now Mahaprabhu said, now Chaturmas is over now, autumn has come now, Sharad Ritu. So, when he met them, Ramananda Rai Swarup Damodar, we will see how Mahaprabhu gets permission to go to Vrindavan.
Mora Sahaya Karayadi Tumi Dui Jana.
Mora Sahaya Karayadi Tumi Dui Jana.
Tabe Ami Yaya Dekhi Shri Vrindavana.
Tabe Ami Yana Dekhi Shri Vrindavana. The Lord requested Ramananda Rai and Swarup Damodar Goswami to help him to go to Vrindavan.
Yeah. So how they can help him? First help they can give is let him go. Because in the previous chapters we have seen, the devotees were very attached to Lord Chaitanya and were worried that in his absence they will feel greatly pained. So whenever Mahaprabhu started the topic of leaving the Jagannath Puri for some other place like South India preaching or going to Vrindavan, the devotees would become silent and morose and wouldn't easily give permission out of intense affection for him. So, therefore Mahaprabhu is requesting them permission now.
Ratriye uthi vanapathe palaya yava.
Ratriye uthi vanapathe palana yava.
Eka ki yaiva ka kaho. Sangena laiva.
Eka ki yaiva kaho. Sangena laiva.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, "I shall leave early in the morning and go incognito, taking the road through the forest. I shall go alone. I shall not take anyone with me."
Yeah. Why? Because leaving early in the morning, nobody, other devotees will be asleep. So he will not have to tackle them, because otherwise others will cry. Some will say, I will come with you. Or some will say, please don't go. Somebody will say, please go later. So he can tackle all the situations by leaving early in the morning, because all the worries will be asleep. And also he says, I shall go alone, he says. Why? Because if somebody accompanies me, you know, he may actually distract me in my purpose. There is another chapter, if you remember, we have studied about how Mahaprabhu said, if Jagadananda comes with me, he will pamper me with a very comfortable bed and very opulent food, and you know, he will offer me facilities which are not fit for a sannyasi to enjoy. And if Mukunda comes, if he sees me jumping and falling on the ground during kirtan, then Mukunda will weep silently. And Nityananda, it's dangerous to take him with me, because he broke my danda in three places and threw it away and said that I broke my danda in my ecstasy. So I can't take such a person with me. And then the Lord said, Damodar Pandit, although he's a brahmachari, he can chastise sannyasis also. So he will find, if he's next to me, he will keep correcting me every now and then. So Mahaprabhu said, if I take any of these people with me, my journey will not be peaceful and my goal of seeing Krishna and Vrindavan will not be achieved. So earlier also Mahaprabhu said, I will not take any of them with me. Actually, these are all called criticisms arising out of affection. So which Mahaprabhu did indirectly, he glorified those four devotees. Now also Mahaprabhu knew that if he says I am going to Vrindavan, all of them will say, whom amongst us you want to come with you? They are going to ask. So before they can ask such a question, Mahaprabhu himself is saying, I am going early in the morning and I shall not take anyone with me. Why? Because if Mahaprabhu chooses one person, others will say, he loves him more than me. He didn't choose me, he chose someone else. I am unfortunate. They may think, if he takes one and neglects the others. So keeping all this in mind, Mahaprabhu said, I will go alone.
केह यदि संग लैते पछे उठी धाया
केह यदि संग लैते पछे उठी
सवरे राखी बाए ना केह नहीं आया
सवरे राखी बाए ना केह नहीं आया
इफ समवन वांट्स टू फॉलो मी प्लीज स्टॉप हिम आई डोंट वांट एनीवन टू गो विथ मी
प्रसन्न है या आज्ञा दिवा नामा निवा दुखा
Please give me your permission with great pleasure and do not be unhappy. If you are happy, I shall be happy on my way to Vrindavan.
Giving permission doesn't mean that you let me go and you loudly cry or you faint on the ground, falling in the ground unconscious like Gadadhar Pandit did before. Because of that, Mahaprabhu said, because Gadadhar cried and fainted and I gave him displeasure, I broke his heart. So my last endeavor to go to Vrindavan was unsuccessful. So I have to come back, Mahaprabhu said. So this time you all please, with a smile on your face, happily allow me to go to Vrindavan, he said. So even in India, there is a ritual, there is a custom. If somebody is going out of home, if they say, I am going, then they will not allow them to go. What they should say? I am going and coming. I am going and coming. Or some people simply say, I am coming. Although, where are they? What are they doing? They are actually going out, but they are saying, I am coming. Like that they say. In Marathi, they say, Eto. Correct, na? Eto means what? I am coming. Correct, na? But why they say? Because if you say, I am going, it's a sentiment of the people get hurt that he may not come back. So therefore they say like that. So Mahaprabhu said, you have to happily allow me to go, not that you cry. What he's saying.
Duijana kahe tumi Ishwara Swatantra.
Duijana kahe tumi Ishwara Swatantra.
Yehi Ichcha Sehi Kariba Naha Paratantra.
Yehi Ichcha Sehi Kariba Naha Paratantra.
Upon hearing this, Ramananda Rai and Swarup Damodar Goswami replied, Dear Lord, you are completely independent. Since you are not dependent on anyone, you will do whatever you desire.
See, they are saying Krishna is Swarat. Swarat means he is totally independent. Nobody can control him. You are the supreme. You are the source of everyone and everything. Who can say no to you for anything? Ultimately, what will happen is your desire. Huh? Who are we to interfere with your desire?
किंतु आमा दुहार सुना एक निवेदने
किंतु आमा दुहार सुना एक निवेदने
तुम्हारा सुखे अमार सुख कहिला अपने
तुम्हारा सुखे अमार सुख कहिला अपने
डियर लॉर्ड काइंडली हियर अवर वन पिटिशन यू हैव ऑलरेडी सेड दैट यू विल डिराइव हैप्पीनेस फ्रॉम अवर हैप्पीनेस दिस इज योर ओन स्टेटमेंट
So, because you already said our happiness is your happiness, we will tell you what is our happiness. We will tell you. And then it's up to you whether you want to fulfill it or not. It's called as tat sukhi sukhitvam, we call it. That means when there is an intimate relationship between people, one does not selfishly crave for one's own happiness. One finds happiness in others' happiness. So, Jiva Goswami Pada, he gives an example of how a man working in a town, you know, he has left his village and come to the town to work, but then he earns some money. Most part of the money he sends to wife and son, so that she can wear a good sari and son can drink milk and go to school. And he keeps very meager amount for himself. But although he is living in a, you know, mosquito infested place and struggling for eating only once a day and all that, but his happiness and smile comes from remembering his wife and child smiling happily. Similarly, in advanced stages of devotional service, a devotee always derives delight in seeing Lord happy. It's called as opulence for the Lord and poverty for oneself, we call it. So, but the devotee, even in a poverty stricken state, is most jubilant because he sees Lord is happy. When Sanatan was living in a very simple way in Vrindavan, he told Kapoor, one businessman who wanted to give some money, he said, build a beautiful temple for Lord Madan Mohan. So when Madan Mohan got a great temple, Sanatan was very happy. Although he himself was wearing simply kopi and a kantashita, simple cloth he was wearing, and living in a thatched cottage. Similarly, here also devotees are saying that you have already declared our happiness is your happiness. We will tell you this is our happiness.
आमा दुहार मने तबे बड़ सुख हया
आमा दुहार मने तबे बड़ सुख
एक निवेदन यदि धर दयामया
एक निवेदन यदि धर दनामया
इफ यू विल प्लीज एक्सेप्ट जस्ट वन रिक्वेस्ट वी शैल बी वेरी वेरी हैप्पी
उत्तम भ्रमण एक संगे अवश्य चाही
उत्तम ब्राह्मण एक संगे अवश्य चाहिए
भिक्षा करी भिक्षा दिबे यावे पात्र वही
भिक्षा करी भिक्षा दिबे यावे पात्र वही
अवर लॉर्ड प्लीज टेक वन वेरी नाइस ब्राह्मण विथ यू ही विल कलेक्ट आर्म्स फॉर यू कुक फॉर यू गिव यू प्रसादम एंड कैरी युअर वाटर पॉट व्हाइल ट्रैवलिंग
या यू कैन कैरी युअर थिंग्स यू कैन कलेक्ट आर्म्स फॉर यू can cook for you, assist you, and can carry your items with you.
Vanapate yate nahi bhojyanna brahmana
Vanapate yate nahi bhojyanna brahmana
Agnyakara sange chaluka viprayeka jana
Agnyakara sange chaluka viprayeka jana
When you go through the jungle, there will be no brahmana available from whom you can accept lunch. Therefore, please give permission for at least one pure brahmana to accompany you.
When Mahaprabhu would go through villages, many brahmanas would come and invite him. So Mahaprabhu would go to their home, do sankirtan, preach to them, and take prasadam also. And he would stay with them and then make them Vaishnavas. And that he would do. But then between one village and another, sometimes there were long forest pathways. It is mentioned in CC that Mahaprabhu and his assistant would just sleep by the side of the pathway. Can you imagine? He would just retire for the night in the jungle itself. And at that time, his assistant would gather some vegetables and, you know, fruits and berries and everything and cook something on the pathway while traveling. So, at that time, because there is no one hosting him for prasadam, they said it's important for you to have an assistant. प्रभु कहे निज संगी काहो ना लैबा
प्रभु कहे निज संगी कान्ह ना लैबा
एक जने नीले आने मने दुख है बा
एक जने नीले आने मने दुख है बा
श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु सेड आई शैल नॉट टेक एनी ऑफ माय एसोसिएट्स विद मी बिकॉज इफ आई चूज समवन ऑल द अदर्स विल बी अनहैप्पी
ನೂತನ ಸಂಗಿ ಹೈ ಬೇಕ ಸ್ನಿಗ್ಧ ಯಾರ ಮನ
ನೂತನ ಸಂಗಿ ಹೈ ಬೇಕ ಸ್ನಿಗ್ಧಯನ್ನ
ಐಚೆಯವೆ ಪಾಯಿತವೆ ಲೈ ಏಕ ಜನ
ಐಚೆಯವೆ ಪಾಯಿತವೆ ಲೈ ಏಕ ಜನ
ಸಚ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಪೀಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಪ್ಟೇನ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಐ ಶಿಲ್ ಅಗ್ರಿ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಹಿಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೀ
ವೈ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ Now, older devotees, nobody can feel that I am unwanted. Because if he is taking a new man, because all the older devotees are in one category and somebody is not so senior, not so close to Mahaprabhu yet. If he takes such a person, others cannot feel that amongst ours, our equals, he has taken one and he didn't take me. They can't feel like that. So, he asked for a new man. And then he also said he must have a peaceful mind, because if he is not peaceful in mind, if he is agitated, then instead of he taking care of Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu has to take care of him. Correct, no? Like Prabhupada used to have Shruti Kirti Prabhu as his assistant. Prabhupada loved him very much. And Shruti Kirti Prabhu hardly went to be with his family, with wife and family. So, one of the days, after many years of serving Prabhupada, one of the days Shruti Kirti Prabhu told Prabhupada that, Prabhupada, my wife has been telling I never came home for a long time. And you also have been telling me I should go. I never could go. So he said that I don't want to mention the name of the devotee, one N Das, one devotee. He is, they have fixed him for you for a short while. I'll come back as soon as possible. When Prabhupada heard the name, he said, no. Prabhupada initially accepted, but afterwards he said no. Because he said, when he is walking with me to airport, I am going ahead, he is looking somewhere else. In some other, looking at somebody. So, a person with a chapaladrik or a disturbed eyes, disturbed mind, he can't be a good personal assistant. A personal assistant should be very attentive to the needs of the master. He should actually anticipate the needs of the master in advance. And he should be very attentive and alert in rendering service. And you should put aside his personal prejudices, his personal attachments and his personal pleasures, selfish pleasures. You should put them all aside and think of always the need of the master whom he is serving. If you want to know more on this, you can read this verse. Vishrambena Atma Shauchena Gauravena Baliyasa. Like that, there is a verse in third canto about our Devahuti, how she served Kardama Muni. She served with respect, she served with respect, she also served with intimacy, it is said. What is intimacy? Intimacy means you know the needs of the person. It's getting cold in the night, for example, then you arrange a special blanket for sleeping. Similarly, if a person has finished eating prasad, then you immediately make sure the water is available. After some time, water will be needed, isn't it? Similarly, if a person is about to getting ready to go out in an hour, you arrange for the car, the driver, everything ready. That means anticipate and serve, and also know the person's nature. What a person likes, what a person doesn't like. Like for example, everybody has a different personality. If somebody comes to meet a person during prasad, some master may say, don't entertain anyone during my prasad. Then, knowing these things, the person servant should act. Knowing the intentions of the master, one should act. So therefore, it's not very easy to do personal servant service. So he's saying that you must have a peaceful mind. If he is only troubled mind he has, then he won't be taking care of me. I have to take care of him. And if I can obtain such a man, I shall agree to take him with me. So if you see here, he says, see the words that he uses. Snigdha. Snigdha not only means very peaceful, Snigdha also means very affectionate. He should serve the master affectionately. This is one of the most vital qualifications for serving any master. Because you will see that when you are affectionate to somebody, you don't put too many conditions. Like for example, many times Prabhupada's servants would assist Prabhupada, and Prabhupada would go to your home. During the lecture, he will be playing mridangam, and then he will be arranging the things for Prabhupada. When Prabhupada is eating prasad, at that time a servant is not supposed to eat same time. Rather, he will be arranging, making sure the car is ready, making sure the next program is fixed and all that. And then, minute after prasad, Prabhupada will board the car and zoom, asleep there. So, person servant, he did not get to eat. So, what he should do? If he is intelligent, he will tell the family, "See, I am going to rush with Prabhupada. Can you please pack a prasadam packet? And if you can give me." So, they will pack and keep it ready. When Prabhupada is leaving, you just put the packet in your bag and go ahead. And when you are in the car behind, you can eat. When Prabhupada is chanting in the front, and he wants recluse, he is with himself, then you can eat. So, a person servant cannot actually tell Prabhupada, "Please wait, I am going to eat now." Can you say that? You can't say that. So, therefore, if he is affectionate to the master, he will not blame the master. Sometimes it may become 10:30, 11 at night, and morning he may have to get up at 3. He can't say that, "No, see, I got only 4 hours yesterday, so day rest, 2 hours I have to compensate." You can't say those things. Yeah, sometimes 2-3 days will be very stretched. After Prabhupada leaves and goes to another place, then our next week will be very cool. So, one should know in crisis how to adjust and not criticize the master, not blame the master, not give up the service to master, not escape from the service, not go around telling that this fellow is exploitative and things like that. So, therefore, if you are affectionate, you won't do any of this. Because where there is love, people are ready to stretch. Where there is love, people are ready to sacrifice. Where there is love, people are ready to lay down their life also. Therefore, the word stigda means actually very affectionate relationship with the master. He actually delights in serving the master, and he feels that it's a privilege, it's an opportunity, such an amazing chance I got in my life to serve this wonderful soul, great soul. He feels, that's how Shrutigati Prabhu served Prabhupada, with great affection. So, Prabhupada had such amazing servants. So, therefore, affectionately serving is important, not just doing the job. And how attentive we should be. In my glorious master book, His Grace Burjan Prabhu gives a beautiful example. Once Prabhupada and a couple of servants were traveling with him. So, he started cooking khichdi for Prabhupada. And then when almost khichdi was halfway through, the two servants came to kitchen and said, "We are also leaving immediately with Prabhupada. So, now when you are cooking khichdi for Prabhupada, can you also make for us? So, we will pack and take it. Prabhupada will eat here, but we will pack and take it." So, Prabhuji was wondering, "Oh, now Prabhupada khichdi will get ready in another 10 minutes. But after that, if I separately start cooking for these fellows, then that will take another half an hour. But by the time they have to leave. So, what to do?" He thought. Then he added more water in that only. And I put more rice and everything. And he started making. It was getting little delayed. Prabhupada asked, "Where is prasad? Is it ready?" He was asking. So, he was trying to make it as. Ultimately, the whatever fire you have in that. So, he somehow made it. And because he increased the flame very much, it was catching at the bottom or whatever. So, when he gave it to Prabhupada, it was not cooked well. The rice was. It's not so cooked so well. So, Prabhupada didn't like it, he was telling. So, later on he came up with a lesson Burjan Prabhu gives in that pastime. He says that, you know, when we are serving the spiritual master, we have to be very alert and attentive. So, in such situations, one has to know how to adjust the situation. So, one has to know, this I am already cooking for Prabhupada, going to be ready, let me not spoil it. I have to keep that only. And separately I should have cooked. Like that he says. Because sometimes at the spur of the moment you have to make a decision in such things. Similarly, another pastime I heard from His Grace Prabhu. Transcendental Diary, he wrote now. Harishavari Prabhu, he was telling. He said one time he was personal assistant to Prabhupada. Prabhupada's body was very emaciated and bony. And the skin was so soft at that time. So, Prabhupada was very much unable to get up and walk to the bathroom slowly. Somebody has to give him the hand. So he was told that he should not move anywhere. He should be available with Prabhupada. So he was there with Prabhupada and he would do that. But then there was a jar kept next to Prabhupada with water. And that water should always be there in the night. So Prabhupada told him, don't leave me and go anywhere. He had agreed. But then the jar was empty. So he was looking at Prabhupada. Prabhupada was sleeping. So should I take this jar? He has to go 2-3 floors down and fetch water and come back, which will take about, say, 7-8 minutes to bring water. Or if I go now, in between Prabhupada gets up, then what will happen? He was in two minds what to do. Then he saw Prabhupada was deeply asleep. So he thought, nothing will happen. Quickly, I'll come back. So he went down and took the water and came. When he came back, he didn't find Prabhupada in the bed. He had gone into the washroom. So Prabhuji immediately kept the water down and was standing just outside the bathroom. And Prabhupada opened the door and was coming out. He stumbled then. He was about to fall. So Prabhuji caught his hand. Prabhupada asked, why did you go away? Why you didn't stand here? He said, Prabhupada, I went to fetch water. I'm sorry. He was telling. And then he asked Prabhupada the question, in such situation, what I should have done? Correct. Prabhupada said, that requires some intelligence. He said, intelligence means what you may have to do, probably you have to just go out of the room and clap hands and call some devotee. Probably go and fetch water. I am with Prabhupada, whatever. Anyway, there could be different ways one can do. But what I am saying is, a servant should learn to affectionately serve the master. Can I please read the purport?
Formerly, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to South India, a Brahmana named Kalakrishna Das went with him. Kalakrishna Das fell victim to a woman, and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had to take the trouble to free him from the clutches of the gypsies. Therefore, the Lord here says that he wants a new man who is peaceful in mind.
Yeah, if he is not peaceful, he is chapaladrik, he will be staring at, you know, some woman on the way and he won't be able to serve the master effectively. Yeah. But one who is peaceful in mind can focus on the service. Yeah.
One whose mind is not peaceful is agitated by certain drives, especially sex desire. Even though he be in a company of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, such a man will become a victim of women and will fall down even in the company of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Maya is so strong that unless one is determined not to fall victim, even the Supreme Personality of Godhead cannot give protection. The Supreme Lord and His representative always want to give protection, but a person must take advantage of their personal contact. If one thinks that the Supreme Personality of Godhead or His representative is an ordinary man, he will certainly fall down. Thus, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not want a person like Kalakrishna Das to accompany him.
Yeah, so two points are mentioned here. So, one point is about, if a person is not peaceful in mind, he will chase after women and he can't be a good servant. That's one point. Another point is, the Supreme Lord and His devotee are both trying to give us protection. But sometimes, while offering protection, if they make some strict rules, honest avoidance of opposite sex and everything, then sometimes a servant becomes annoyed. Why am I being so strictly handled? And he may start offending the master. He may start finding fault with the master. He may start offending the master. And then such a devotee falls down. So, therefore, then while mistreating the master, then one may consider him an ordinary man. By thinking of him to be an ordinary man, then a person falls down. Therefore, Mahaprabhu thought that Kalakrishna Das could not take advantage of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna himself. He couldn't take advantage. Why are we not able to take advantage? Atiparichaya, avajnat. Familiarity breeds contempt. Like for example, when something is easily available, we take it very cheaply. Like you will see that, like you all will have experience, when you go to some unknown place, a new temple someplace, there will be hundreds of people welcoming, putting garland and click, 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 so many photos, correct, no? And the Prabhuji is coming and then people will be taking from different angles. You have seen that, how people take photos, isn't it? They take videos, and the congregation, brahmacharis, boys, they will just abound and packed up. Everybody, because people have heard about this person, either they heard on YouTube or they have seen videos, or they have read his books, or they have heard his fame from different people, although they have never associated. So there is a lot of eagerness. But if that same person is coming regularly, or he is a local devotee only, is locally available, then what do you think will happen? People may take it very lightly. They may not consider it so. Like one fellow was living in Jagannathpuri, in the temple was here at a stone's throw from his house. So one of his relatives came to take darshan of Jagannath. So he told, then the devotee put his luggage, everything in the house, and said, I will go to take darshan of Jagannath. Then he asked this man, have you taken darshan of Jagannath? How often you go? He said, no, I came to this city 4 years ago, but have not yet gone. He said, really? 4 years you are in Jagannathpuri, you doing a job, and you didn't go to Jagannath's temple to take darshan. You know what he said? Anyway, Jagannath is here only. Where will he go? He's not going to run away. I can always take darshan, he said. And in this way, 4 years he never took darshan. And this is a relative coming from a very far away place, 50 hours away. Is coming to take darshan of Jagannath. So this is called Atiparichayat Avajnat. Familiarity breeds contempt. Yeah. So therefore, what happens when familiarity comes? When familiarity breeds contempt, we commit offenses. That's the result of that. For example, the Yadukumaras, they were very intimate associates of Lord Krishna in Dwaraka. So actually, the sages and saintly people should be handled very, very carefully and alertly and attentively. Otherwise, even slight deviation in offering respects to them could lead to, you know, paying a very big price. Many examples could be said. You know, Indradumna Raja was sitting and Agastya Muni and disciples came. He sort of, he closed his eyes and he was meditating. He ignored. Result, he became an elephant in the next life, Gajendra. You take Indra sitting with his wife Sachi on elevated throne and all demigods praising him and showering flowers upon him and fanning him. When his spiritual master came into the assembly, Brihaspati, he every day he would see him coming. He would offer obeisances. But today he didn't offer obeisances. He sort of ignored him. And that's it. He lost all his opulences. So we could give innumerable examples like this. When great souls are ignored, like Durvasa Muni is giving his Maha Garland to Indra, affectionately. Because why do great souls give Mahagarland to some younger souls? Just to bless them. But then Indra was at that time little careless and inattentive. Somehow he took the garland and gave it to the Airavat elephant. And the elephant, being a foolish animal, it put the garland down and trampled on it. And Durvasa Muni looked behind. He said, oh, this is what you are doing with the Mahagarland I gave you? That means you don't respect me. Because you don't respect me, you didn't respect the garland that I gave you. And the result, he lost all his opulences. You will see that. So, therefore, here you find Kalakrishna is traveling with Mahaprabhu, but he could not take advantage of Mahaprabhu's association. So, he sort of ignored him or neglected him or did not take his, at that time he could not understand his value. So, he became attracted by gypsies and he fell away. You know? Therefore, Mahaprabhu refused to take anybody like that. He wanted someone who was determined, who had a peaceful mind, and one who was not agitated by ulterior motives. Three things he says. You should be determined, and you should have a very calm, peaceful mind. And he is not agitated by kama, lust, and you know, other things like that. Swarupa kaheyai bala bhadra bhattacharya.
स्वरूप कहे बलभद्र भट्टाचार्य
तोमतेसु स्निग्ध बड पंडित साधु आर्य
तोमतेसु स्निग्ध बड पंडित साधु आर्य स्वरूप दामोदर देन सेड हियर इज बलभद्र भट्टाचार्य हु हैज ग्रेट लव फॉर यू ही इज एन हॉनेस्ट लर्न्ड स्कॉलर एंड ही इज एडवांस्ड इन स्पिरिचुअल कॉन्शियसनेस
सी व्हाट आर द वर्ड्स ही इज यूजिंग हियर इफ यू सी about Bhattacharya, saying that susnigdha, he is very affectionate to you. And bada pandita, he is very educated, learned. Sadhu is honest. Arya, advanced in spiritual consciousness. So four things he is saying. Tomate susnigda, bada pandita, sadhu, Arya. You know, Arya, anarya, anarya jushtam asvargyam akirtikaram Arjuna Krishna says. Arya means one who is spiritually sound, is following dharma varipaka perfectly. And here the word sadhu means Prabhupada says honest. And is learned devotee and is affectionate to you.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted a new man, not a person like Kala Krishna Das, who would fall for women. Swarup Damodar therefore immediately pointed out a new Brahman named Balabhadra Bhattacharya. Sri Swarup Damodar Goswami had studied this person very thoroughly and had seen that he had great love for Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Not only did he love the Lord, but he was also learned and honest. He was not duplicitous and he was advanced in Krishna consciousness. According to a Bengali proverb,
Adi bhakti chorer lakshan.
Too much devotion is a symptom of a thief. A person who assumes himself to be a devotee but mentally is thinking of something else is duplicitous. One who is not duplicitous is called sadhu.
Yeah. Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur tells a story. There was one pujari who was appointed by a Jamindar, you know, to worship the family deity. But the Jamindar was a miserly fellow. He was not giving sufficient salary. But the Jamindar would tell this Brahmana pujari sometimes to, he would get 2 dozen big, big bananas. He would tell him, please offer to deity and give me. So the Brahmana thought, anyway, he's not giving me more money. At least I can, you know, stock some of these items which he is telling me to offer. So he would take 3 or 4 bananas and cut and keep it aside. So the big fellow Jamindar understood that he is stocking something secretly without giving me the whole thing. So one of the days Jamindar and the pujari came. You know, of course Jamindar didn't ask. He told one man to check with him. You ask him about whether he has offered what I gave. When that man went to ask the Brahman pujari, the Jamindar is asking whether you offered. He said, did I know? Do you think I stole? I never stole. Neither he was telling. You know, I have given you everything. So actually he never asked about stealing. But still what he said? You know, do you think I have stolen? So why is he asking I have stolen? Because he had actually stolen. Time to time he has been stealing like that. So therefore, this is a duplicitous behavior. Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur says that some people have a duplicitous behavior. So they show excessive good behavior. Like when Jamindar would come, big folding the palms and falling at the feet, as if, you know, his behavior would be like extra additionally respectful because he wants to hide his cheating nature. Correct, no? So anybody who puts up a show of show bottle devotion while hiding the truth is called as Adi Bhakti Chorer Lakshan, it is said. Yeah. So, your devotee of the Lord should be honest. He should not be duplicitous. Duplicitous means sweet talking on face, bad mouthing on back. Or behaving nicely in the front, but being naughty behind. Or telling good about a person in the front. Oh, you are this, you are that. I am so much in veneration of you, this and that. After the person goes, you say he is a fool. You know, he did this, he did that. There are people like that. This is called what behavior? Duplicitous behavior. So, actually some Vaishnavas are very advanced. Like one devotee was telling in South India, if somebody would come and tell them about some another devotee, this devotee would immediately say that, you know, you see, that is the devotee's account with Krishna. You know, why should we talk about it? Why should we comment about it? This devotee would say, let us mind our own business. Let us focus on our devotion service. Just like you go to a hospital, every patient has an account with doctor and they have their papers and all, correct, no? Now, should one patient worry about another patient? Is it necessary? Not necessary. If you are bothering, then people will ask you, are you the doctor? So, whoever is doctor, they will worry about the patient. If you are sitting in the outside, better take a book with you to read so that you don't look at patients who is doing what, isn't it? So, yeah, one who is not duplicitous is called sadhu. And then?
Swarup Damodar immediately pointed out that Balabhadra Bhattacharya was quite fit to accompany the Lord because he was a learned scholar and was simple and had great love for Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was also advanced in Krishna consciousness, therefore he was considered appropriate for accompanying the Lord as a personal servant. The words snigdha, very peaceful, and susnigdha, affectionate, are used in verses.
So the earlier verse said the word snigdha, peaceful. This verse says susnigdha, affectionate. Yeah.
Are used in verses 14 and 15 respectively. And they are also found in Srimad Bhagavatam.
Bruyuh snigdhasya shishyasya guruvo guhyamapyuta.
A disciple who has actual love for his spiritual master is endowed by the blessings of the spiritual master with all confidential knowledge. Srila Sridhar Swami has commented that the word snigdhasya means premavata. The word premavata indicates that one has great love for his spiritual master.
Mm. So, how can you know that one has great love for the spiritual master? Then one should not act in a way that will bring displeasure to the heart of the spiritual master. Mm. Prabhupada said, as simple as that. Mm. Yeah, Prabhupada would talk about the Christians. He would challenge some of the Christians when he went abroad that, you say you love Jesus, you say you love Christ, then why are you killing the animals? Because in that one of the Ten Commandments says, thou shalt not kill. And then that means you are not following the instruction. That means you are not loving. So your love has no meaning at all. If somebody says, no, I love my master very much, but I will not do what he says. That means your love is what love? Sentimental love. It is not actually complete love. Sentimental love means you have some sentiment, but you don't follow the instruction. So, and also, how do you know somebody has a great love for a spiritual master? He is very attentive to the instructions given and makes strenuous efforts to fulfill those instructions, no matter what. And the disciple should give the first priority for fulfilling those instructions and put aside all other things that may come in the way of fulfilling those instructions. Any other stumbling block that might come. And if a disciple is unable to follow the instruction, then one should go to the spiritual master and cry and beg for his blessings, beg for his guidance, beg for his mercy. So, because that is a sign of affection. Therefore, susnigdha means he is in love with you. He has great affection for you. Love is from the heart. You know, alignment out of duty is from the head. Because from the head, sometimes we align with the duties given because we know if I don't align, it will not be good for me. We do like that. But affection awakens from the heart of a devotee. So then, therefore he says that he is snigdha, he is so snigdha, he is peaceful, he is affectionate. And also one more quality he had said, what was it? Premavata and susnigdha are same only. Before, one more quality of him in this verse he said, Pandita, learned, isn't it? Yeah, he's a Bada Pandita, Sadhu, honest. These are totally three qualities totally. Four qualities, see. First of all, in the previous verse, Snigdha, peaceful in mind. Then in this verse, Susnigdha, affectionate. Then Bada Pandita, one should be learned also. Because you go from Kanishtha to Madhyam to Uttam, then Madhyam Adhikari is more learned than Kanishtha Adhikari. Bada Pandita, that is third quality. And Sadhu is honest. That is the fourth quality, isn't it? And Arya is advanced in spiritual consciousness, fifth quality. We'll repeat the qualities. What are they? Snigdha, Susnigdha, Bada Pandita, Sadhu, Arya. Yeah. Here are the qualities. Yeah. Pratamei toma sange aila gauda haite.
Pratamei toma sange aila gauda
haite. Iharai cha ache sarva tirtha karite.
Inarai cha ache sarva tirtha karite.
In the beginning, he came with you from Bengal. It is his desire to visit and see all the holy places of pilgrimage.
ಇಹರ ಸಂಘೆ ಆಚೆ ವಿಪ್ರ ಏಕ ಭೃತ್ಯ
ಇಹರ ಸಂಘೆ ಆಚೆ ವಿಪ್ರ ಏಕ ಭೃತ್ಯ
ಇಹೋ ಪತೆ ಕರಿಬೇನ ಸೇವಾ ಭಿಕ್ಷಾ ಕೃತ್ಯ
ಇನ್ಹೋ ಪತೆ ಕರಿಬೇನ ಸೇವಾ ಭಿಕ್ಷಾ ಕೃತ್ಯ
ಇನ್ ಅಡಿಷನ್ ಯು ಮೇ ಟೇಕ್ ಅನದರ್ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಣ್ ಹೂ ವಿಲ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫುಡ್.
So in the earlier verse it was said, he also has a desire to see all the pilgrimage sites in Bengal when you are going, it said, which is not a problem. But that desire should not be put prior to service to the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If somebody has a desire that I also want to see those holy places and he is going to go to holy places, I have never seen Vrindavan, I also want to see. Yeah, you can have the desire, it's a spiritual desire. But it should be made subordinate to the will of the master, desire of the master.
ಇಹಾರೆ ಸಂಗೆ ಲಹಯ ದೇ ಸಬಾರ ಹಯ ಸುಖ ಇನ್ಹಾರ ಸಂಗೆ ಲಹಯ ದೇ ಸಬ ಹಯ ಸುಖ
ವನಪತೆ ಆಯ್ತೆ ತುಮಾರ ನಹಿ ಬೇಕೋನ ದುಃಖ
ವನಪತೆ ಆಯ್ತೆ ತುಮಾರ ನಹಿ ಬೇಕೋನ ದುಃಖ
ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೇಕ್ ಹಿಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಇಫ್ ಟೂ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಗೋ ವಿತ್ ಯು ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಜಂಗಲ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ಲಿ ಬಿ ನೋ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟಿ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕನ್ವೀನಿಯನ್ಸ್.
ಸೇ ವಿಪ್ರವಹಿನಿ ಬೇ ವಸ್ತ್ರಾಂಬು ಭಾಜನ
ಸೇ ವಿಪ್ರವಹಿನಿ ಬೇ ವಸ್ತ್ರಾಂಬು ಭಜನ
ಭಟ್ಟಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಭಿಕ್ಷಾ ದಿವೇ ಕರಿ ಭಿಕ್ಷಾಟನ
ಭಟ್ಟಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಭಿಕ್ಷಾ ದಿವೇ ಕರಿ ಭಿಕ್ಷಾಟನ
ದ ಅದರ್ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮನ್ ಕೆನ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಯುವರ್ ಕ್ಲಾತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಪಾಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಲಭದ್ರ ಭಟ್ಟಾಚಾರ್ಯ ವಿಲ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕುಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು
ಒನ್ ಅಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಯುವರ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ಸ್ and Balabhadra will cook for you, so you have nothing to worry and they both will take care of you everything.
Tahara vachana prabhu angikara kaila
Tahara vachana prabhu angikara kaila
Balabhadra Bhattacharya sangikari nila
Balabhadra Bhattacharya sangikari nila.
Thus Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted the request of Swarup Damodar Pandit and agreed to take Balabhadra Bhattacharya with him.
Now, the next part, 21 to 46, Lord Chaitanya passes through the Jharikhanda forest. It's a very, very interesting section. Let's proceed.
Purvaratriye Jagannatha Dekhi Agyalaya
Purvaratriye Jagannatha Dekhi Agyalaya
Shesharatre Uthi Prabhu Chalila Lukhaya
Shesharatre Uthi Prabhu Chalila Lukhaya.
On the previous night, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had visited Lord Jagannath and taken his permission. Now, near the end of the night, the Lord got up and started immediately. He was not seen by others.
See, generally great souls, you will always see, they treat the deity form of the Lord as good as a person. And they feel a personal connection with him. When they come into a particular place, they have to go and report to deity that I have come back to Puri. When they are leaving, then they have to go to the deities and report that I am going for such and such venture, preaching venture or holy dham visit venture. Please give me your blessing. May I always remember you. Let me never forget you. So they take permission. In home also you will see, when a child or a kid is going to go out somewhere, he will always take permission from father or mother, some elder person. Have you seen anybody not telling anybody and just boom going away? You will not see that. Similarly, a devotee of the Lord, for devotee, Lord is the mother, he is the father, he is the relative. And devotee cannot do anything without involving the Lord in his life. Lord has to be involved. Any good thing you start or any challenges you faced, yes, Lord has to be involved immediately. So Mahaprabhu is now going for a Vrindavan tour and is going to Jagannath to take his permission also. First he took devotee's permission. When they gave permission, then he's taking Lord's permission now. So and then as he had actually planned, the early morning hours, it was dark. He got up and started immediately without being seen by others.
Pratakale Bhaktagana Prabhu Nadekiya
Pratakale Bhaktagana Prabhu Nadekiya
Anveshana Karifire Vyakulahaya
Anveshana Karifire Vyakulahaya.
Because the Lord had departed, the devotees, unable to see him early in the morning, began to search for him with great anxiety.
This reminds me of Lord Ramachandra along with Lakshman and Sita. When Lord Rama was proceeding ahead in the chariot, many Ayodhyavasis were walking behind. Even old Brahmanas are walking, and Ram felt very, very pained to see that. He said, if they are going to walk, then I will also get down and walk. How can I make old Brahmanas who are fit enough to bless me, they are in anxiety walking behind me and I am going ahead. So, then later on, these people followed Rama up to the forest. And in one place, it was getting late, darker at night, they were planning to rest. So, in the bank of a river, all of them rested. Then Lord Rama also rested. But very early in the morning, he got up and he wrote Sumantra, who was driving the chariot. He told them that, you take my chariot in this route, then you turn it around and then come back, then you go in another route. So like this, you make the chariot wheels press the ground in few different ways, so they will never come to know in which direction the chariot went. And he said, why? Because look at all the sleeping Ayodhyavasis, how much affection they have for me. You know, they have left their homes behind, and their wives have told them that don't return back without Ram. You have to bring Ram back with you. So all these men, they are all our lovers. Their hearts are filled with devotion. When I look at them, I feel pity. And they won't be able to accompany us for the 14 years, nor are they expected to. So it's becoming very difficult for me to, because I am caught up in this very strongly bound network of our love and affection by these people. So if I am letting them wake up, they will not let me go. So let us do like this. Sumantra did precisely that. Ram went along with his wife Sita and Lakshman. When these people got up, they loudly cried. They didn't find Ram. As if, you know, a fellow who got a big treasure of, you know, 20 crore rupees and he lost the money. They fell like that. They cried. So in the same manner here also, the devotees, when they woke up in the morning, and they began to search for Lord Chaitanya and they couldn't find, they became very much anxious.
Swarupa Gosai Sabaya Kaila Nivarana.
Swarupa Gosai Sabaya Kaila Nivarana.
Nivritta Haya Rahe Sabe Jani Prabhu Ramana.
Nivritta Hana Rahe Sabe Jana Prabhu Ramana.
While all the devotees were searching for the Lord, Swarup Damodar restrained them. Then everyone fell silent, knowing the mind of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Swarup Damodar told them, you have no need to search. All of you do your devotional service. Go back. And everybody understood. Because Swarup Damodar is the most intimate associate of Lord Chaitanya. And he knows the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So if he is telling the people, don't search for Mahaprabhu, nobody will search. Because they understood that Mahaprabhu has gone with his permission. They understood that.
Prasiddha Pata Chadi Prabhu Upapate Chalila.
Prasiddha Pata Chadi Prabhu Upapate Chalila.
Katakadahine Kari Vane Praveshila.
Katakadahine Kari Vane Praveshila.
The Lord abandoned walking on the well-known public road and went instead along a bypass. He thus kept the city of Kataka on his right as he entered the forest.
So because if he goes on the public road, somebody can run and find out where is he, correct? No? So Mahaprabhu abandoned the, just like Lord Rama did also. So he went along a bypass and then he went, keeping that up on the right side.
Nirjana vane chale Prabhu Krishna namalaya.
Nirjana vane chale Prabhu Krishna namalaya.
Hasti vyagra pata chade Prabhu re dekhiya.
Hasti vyagra patha chade Prabhu re dekhiya.
When the Lord passed through the solitary forest chanting the holy name of Krishna, the tigers and elephants seeing him gave way.
Pale pale vyagra hasti gandara shukara gana.
Pale pale vyagra hasti gandara shukara gana.
Tara madhye aveshe Prabhu karila gamana.
Tara madhye aveshe Prabhu karila gamana.
When the Lord passed through the jungle in great ecstasy, packs of tigers, elephants, rhinoceros and boars came, and all And the Lord passed right through them.
Amazing, na? Isn't there? No fear.
Dekhi Bhattacharya Ramane Haya Mahabhaya.
Dekhi Bhattacharya Ramane Haya Mahabhaya.
Prabhura Pratapetara Eka Pashahaya.
Prabhura Pratapetara Eka Pashahaya.
Balabhadra Bhattacharya was very much afraid to see them. But by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's influence, all the animals stood to one side.
So they gave way for him to go ahead.
Ekadinapate Vyagra Kariyache Shayana.
Ekadinapate Vyagra Kariyache Shayana.
Aveshe Tara Gaye Prabhura Lagila Charana.
Aveshe Tare Gaye Prabhura Lagila Charana.
One day, a tiger was lying on the path and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, walking along the path in ecstatic love, touched the tiger with his feet.
Actually, Mahaprabhu is looking at the tiger as a living entity who is fast asleep. He is saying, Jiva Jago, Jiva Jago, waking up the tiger to make him chant.
Prabhu kahe kaha Krishna Vyagra Uthila.
Prabhu kahe kaha Krishna Vyagra Uthila.
Krishna Krishna kahe Vyagra Nachite Lagila.
Krishna Krishna kahe Vyagra Nachite Lagila.
The Lord said, chant the holy name of Krishna. The tiger immediately got up and began to dance and to chant Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Aradine Mahaprabhu Kare Nadi Snana.
Aradine Mahaprabhu Kare Nadi Snana.
Matahasti Yutha Aila Karite Jalapana.
Matahasti Yutha Aila Karite Jalapana.
Another day, while Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was bathing in a river, a herd of maddened elephants came there to drink water.
Prabhu jala kritya kare aage hasti aila.
Prabhu jala kritya kare aage hasti aila.
Krishna kata Krishna kaha bali Prabhu jala feli marila.
Krishna kaha bali Prabhu jala feli marila.
While the Lord was bathing and murmuring the Gayatri mantra, the elephants came before him. The Lord immediately splashed some water on the elephants and asked them to chant the name of Krishna. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was the Supreme Personality of Godhead, playing the part of a very great advanced devotee. On the Mahabhagavat platform, the devotee makes no distinction between friends and enemies. On that platform, he sees everyone as a servant of Krishna.
As stated, that Pandita Samadarshana. Like, you know this famous verse. Humble sage, he sees all these things equally. Whether it's one is a learned gentle brahmana or a cow or elephant and dog eater, he sees the soul in everybody. Mahabhagavat?
A Mahabhagavat, being learned and advanced in spiritual consciousness, sees no difference between a tiger, an elephant, or a learned scholar. The test of advanced spiritual consciousness is that one becomes fearless. He envies no one and he is always engaged in the Lord's service. He sees every living entity as an eternal part and parcel of the Lord, rendering service according to his capacity by the will of the Supreme Lord. As Krishna confirms in the
in everyone's heart, Krishna is seated and he provides everything, knowledge, forgetfulness and remembrance. So Mahabhagavat knows that Krishna is in everyone's heart, is dictating. So you all know the pastime of Haridas Thakur living in a cave. There was another mountain serpent living in the same cave. When Vaishnavas went to see, they were shocked. How is he living in this cave and sleeping? Can he peacefully sleep in the same room with one more snake also? You sleep in one side and the snake is sleeping on that side. Can anybody sleep at night? Haridas Thakur is living in such a cave. When Haridas Thakur saw, Vaishnavas was a little afraid that there's a snake. He thought, okay, tonight I will leave this place and go to another place because I think it's the residence of the snake. And the snake felt that, I am disturbing this great devotee Haridas. So he slithered away. He went away. So what Haridas Thakur felt was, even in the heart of a snake, there is super soul. And if super soul tells him not to bite me, he will not bite me. That was his conviction. Here also, he thinks like that. Therefore, Krishna tells the tiger, elephant and boar, here is a Mahabhagavat, do not disturb him. Why then should animals be envious of such a great personality? Read further. Those who are neophytes.
Those who are neophytes or even a little progressed in devotional service should not try to imitate the Mahabhagavat. Rather, they should only follow in his footsteps. The word Anukara means imitating and Anusara means trying to follow in the footsteps. We should not try to imitate the activities of a Mahabhagavat or Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Our best efforts should be exerted in trying to follow them according to our ability. The Mahabhagavat's heart is completely free from material contamination and he can become very dear even to fierce animals like tigers and elephants. Indeed, the Mahabhagavat treats them as his very intimate friends. On this platform, there is no question of envy. When the Lord was passing through the forest, he was in ecstasy, thinking the forest to be Vrindavan. He was simply searching for Krishna.
Yeah. I will show you. So I will show you one very very special verse from this thing. This is from Padma Purana. Please repeat this verse. Enarthito haristena
Enarthito haristena
Tarpitani jagantyapi
Tarpitani jagantyapi
Prajyanti jantavastatra
Prajyanti jantavastatra
Jangama stavara api
Jangama stavara api.
He says that Yena Archito Hari. If somebody is worshipping Lord Krishna, Tena tarpitani jaganti api. All living entities, they find him very pleasing. If somebody is a Krishna devotee wearing a beautiful tela, kantimala, chanting beads, is behaving humbly, tolerantly, respectfully towards all living beings, chanting and dancing, and he does not indulge in sinful activities. When other living entities see that devotee, they not only devotees, even the other living entities, therefore it is a dhira adhira jana priyav, priyakarav. The devotees are very pleasing even for adhiras to see. Like Narada was pleasing even to Hiranyakashipu and Kamsa also. And Ravana also. So they are very pleasing for even ordinary living entities to see. Yena archito haristena tarpitani jagantyapi. Second line he says, Rajyanti jantavastatra jangama stavara api. He is saying, all the inhabitants of the world, both moving and non-moving, are pleasing to him. So he also finds all living entities to be very dear to him because they are all Krishna's children. He sees them as brothers, universal brotherhood with which he sees. So he finds them very lovable and they find him very lovable. Like that this verse says. Amazing verse. This is, that's what he's saying here. When the Lord was passing through the forest, he was in ecstasy. He saw all the animals as jivas. He did not see their external bodies. So in this way, now 32. Yeah, 32. We'll finish this 132. Say jala bindu kane. Say jala bindu kana. Lage yara gaya.
Say jala bindu kana. Lage yara gaya.
Say Krishna Krishna kahe preme nache gaya.
Say Krishna Krishna kahe preme nache gaya. The elephants whose bodies were touched by the water splashed by the Lord began to chant Krishna Krishna and dance and sing in ecstasy.
Keha bhume pade keha karaye chitkara.
Keha bhume pade keha karaye chitkara.
Dekhi Bhattacharya ramane haya chamatkara.
Dekhi Bhattacharya ramane haya chamatkara. Some of the elephants fell to the ground and some screamed in ecstasy. Seeing this, Balabhadra Bhattacharya was completely astonished.
See? So, Mahaprabhu's positive spiritual holy name influence could even cleanse the heart of animals in the forest and could make them chant and dance. Prabhupada made the same thing with hippies. And Haridas Thakur made the same thing with a prostitute who came for some other purpose. So in this way, great souls have the potency and ability to evoke Krishna Prem even in the heart of hippies or degraded people or like animals also. That's why Bhattacharya saw that.
पते आयते करे प्रभु उच्च संकीर्तना
पते आयते करे प्रभु उच्च संकीर्तना
मधुर कंठ ध्वनि सुनी ऐसे मृगी गण
मधुर कंठ ध्वनि सुनी ऐसे मृगी गण
लॉर्ड डिड लाउड संकीर्तन सो बिकॉज दैट व्हाट हैपेंस देयर वर मेनी डियर्स इन द फॉरेस्ट शी डियर्स दे बिकेम वेरी चार्म्ड बाय द स्वीट वॉइस एंड दे स्टार्टेड कमिंग towards Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Generally, deers go away from us or they come close to us. They are afraid when they see humans. They think this fellow will kill me or something. But when they saw Lord Chaitanya, they came towards Mahaprabhu. Like that is mentioned. So, we will stop with this because this section continues. Very, very special section it is. Up to 56 verse it continues. Now we are in 35. So, Lord Chaitanya passing through the Jharikhand forest. So, in today's session, one of the things we did was understanding what is the meaning of a personal servant of Lord Chaitanya, the qualities of an ideal servant. Another thing we learnt is Mahaprabhu entering into Jharikhand forest, creating a spiritual awakening even in the heart of degraded jivas who are put in the body of animals and birds and all. Shri Prabhupada ki, Sujatindra Tamrat ki, thank you very much.